Bollywood, 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 Bollywood. That's one word for a multi-million dollar business that rules our hearts. Rarely do we know what goes on behind the camera and what it takes to make a film. It's so much more than blood, sweat, and tears. It's an art.
Art. Art.
And today, we are going to touch those rarely known facts about Bollywood. Did you know, in the film, heroine Kareena Kapoor wore over 130 different dresses made by designers from all over the globe. Kareena's wardrobe for the film was one of the most expensive out of all the movies ever made in Bollywood, with one of her dresses costing 1.5 crores. Nowadays, it's become a norm that Indian movies release all over the globe. But there was a time that Indian movies did not have that platform. Did you know? Lagaan was the first Indian film to be released in China. It was dubbed and premiered in Shanghai, Beijing.
Chuli ke piche kya hai? Chuli ke piche?
I know, a number of you love this song. A number of you love the choreography in this song. A number of you are a fan of Madhuri Dixit. Today, songs like Meri Kurti Sexy Lagdi Ve,
Main Aayi Hu UP Bihar Lootne,
or
Kundi Mat Kharkao Raja,
etc. etc. These songs are accepted at the drop of a hat. But did you know that film Khalnayak's iconic song, Song Choli Ke Piche, was protested against by a large number of 42 political parties? Kaho Na Pyar Hai, which gifted the Bollywood industry a Greek god and a very versatile actor. But did you know, Kaho Na Pyar Hai film was added to the Guinness Books of World Record for 2002 edition? Yes, the movie won a total of 92 awards, the most number of awards won by any Bollywood film in history. Did you know that the movie Salaam Bombay was released in 1988 and won the Golden Camera and Audience Awards at the Cannes Film Festival? The film, directed by Meera Nair, was also the second Indian film to be nominated for the Academy Award for Best Foreign Language Film. There are many high-budgeted movies made in Bollywood nowadays. There is no doubt about it. But did you know, the entire film of Rawan cost $27 million. DDLJ, yani Dilwale Dulhania Le Jayenge, a movie that won a number of awards, a movie that gave love story a different angle altogether, a movie that also gave us a jhalak of Bollywood Badshah's personal love story also. And the music of DDLJ was just heart-throbbing. But did you know, Mere Khwabon Mein Jo Aaye was the first song to be recorded for DDLJ. Yes, Aditya Chopra rejected 24 verses made by Anand Bakshi before approving the final cut. Bollywood today sees a number of actors who are paid in crores. Any actor who is demanded by the public, who is loved by the public, know their worth and know what to demand from the producers of the movie. But did you know, until 1990, Amitabh Bachchan was the only star paid in crores. K. Asif only directed two films in his life, the second being Mughal-e-Azam, the third Love and God, which was left unfinished because he died at the age of 48. So, can you tell me his first directorial movie? The film Line Queen, the first female leading superstar. Yes, we are talking about none other than the very gorgeous and the very talented who started her acting career at the age of 4 and ended up doing more than 400 films in her acting career. But did you know that Sridevi played Rajnikant's stepmother in a film when she was just 13 years old. She played the character in a Tamil film called Mundru Mudichu. Today, Bollywood has a number of films that has crossed 100 crores, 200 crores and 300 crores club. But do you know which movie opened up the 100 crores club in the Bollywood industry? Yes, it was none other than Mr. Perfectionist, Aamir Khan's Gajni. Gajni was the first film to have crossed 100 crores in the box office. And Three Idiots, being Aamir Khan's film again, was the first film to cross 200 crores in the domestic domain. Kalki Kochlin has done a number of films in Bollywood, and she is mainly praised for her acting skills in the Bollywood industry. But very less know that Kalki Kochlin's great-grandfather was the chief engineer for the construction of the Eiffel Tower. His name was Maurice Kochlin, and he was also in charge of the construction of the Statue of Liberty.